Hello all, welcome to session 92. In this session, I'm going to practically demonstrate and explain about initializing the class variables using init function in Python. So let's get started. In the previous session, I explained about init function. Now in this session, how to use the init function for initializing the class variables, I'm going to explain and practically demonstrate. First of all, I'll open this PyCharm IDE where we have this Python file. Inside this Python file, I need to first create a class, because without creating a class, we cannot create the init function, right? We have to create the init function inside the class only, as explained in the previous session. So let me create a class first, class car. After creating the class car, inside this car class, I'll create the init function. How to create the init function? Def underscore underscore init underscore underscore, like this we have to create. So this is an init function that I created in the previous session only, right? There's no difference between this init function and the previous session init function. So what I'm going to do here is, in this session, okay, inside this init function, I'm going to add additional parameters. Okay, there is a reason why I'm adding these parameters inside this init function here, okay? So I'll add some parameters like model of the car, okay, color of the car, cost of the car. But why I am adding these additional parameters inside this init function? Okay, I want to show you how to initialize the class variables using init function. Okay, these parameters are required for initializing the class variables. But what exactly is meant by initialization, guys? First of all, okay, before I initialize this class variables with this function parameters, init function parameters, I need to first explain what exactly is meant by initialization. If I create a variable like wheels, and if I have to initialize this particular variable, then what I have to do, guys? How to initialize this wheels variable? For that, I have to say is equal to 4. Okay, here is equal to 4 is nothing but initialization. Okay, you are initializing this wheels variable with value 4. That's what is meant by initialization. So hope guys you understood what exactly is initialization. The same thing we are going to do that. Okay, we are going to initialize the class variables. These are the function parameters, not class variables. But we are going to create some class variables and we are going to initialize those class variables with these function parameters. That's what we are going to do with the help of this init function, guys. Okay, here, how to create the class variables inside this init function. In order to create the class variables, I have to use the self convention. Okay, there's something known as self here. You see self dot. Okay, that means whatever the variable you created here, that will belong to the class variable. If you append this self dot variable, that will become the class variable. If I say self dot model, this self dot model and this model is not same. Okay, this self dot model and this model is not same. This model, which one is highlighted here, you see, I'm moving my mouse, right? This one is the function parameter, whereas this model is the class variable. Okay, here, if you create self.model, it becomes a class variable. Self.model is equal to, I'm initializing, using the function parameters, I am initializing the class variable. Okay, self.model is equal to model. Similarly, I want to initialize the other class variables like color and cost. Self.color is equal to color. This color is this parameter, okay, function parameter. And this is the class variable that we are creating. Self dot cost is equal to cost, okay? So we initialized all the class variables. Here the class variables are self dot model, self dot color, and self dot cost. Model, color, and cost are the function parameters. They are not the class variables. Left sides are the class variables, right sides are the function parameters, simple. And this, okay, this process is known as initializing. Initialization, okay? Using the init function, we are initializing the class variables. This process is known as initialization. Okay, the main purpose of init function in Python, the main purpose of using the init function in Python is to initialize the class variables. That's why we use the init function, guys. Fine, most of the cases. Fine, that's the main purpose I am saying, okay? Now here I'll create another function, say print car details, okay? Print car details like this. So here, I'll print all these class variables. Okay, if the initialization is successful, okay, using the init function, if this particular initialization is successful, then if you call this print car details function of this car class, then this should print all the proper details. Okay, I'll print all the details. Print the model of the car is, the model of the car is, what is the model of the car? This self dot model, okay, if the initialization is done, then self dot model will be printed properly. Self dot model, okay. Similarly, I'll print the the color of the car and cost of the car. The color of the car is comma self dot color. Then print, I'm printing the class variables. As you can see here, I'm printing the class variables. The cost of the car is, okay, self dot cost, that's it, okay? So inside this car class, we created two functions. One is init function, whose purpose, main purpose is to initialize the class variables. And second variable purpose is to just print out all the class variables, okay? If the initialization is done properly using the init function, then this printing will happen in a proper way, okay? That's why we created two functions here. Now, when does this particular init function will be called? As already explained in the previous session, whenever you create an object for the car class, automatically, okay, you don't have to call it specifically, guys. When you create an object for the car class, automatically this init function will be called, okay? So this is the way, right? So far I explained, creating an object for the class, this is the format, right? If you want to create an object for the car class here, you have to say name of the class followed by the parentheses, okay? Circular brackets. This will create an object. Here object is created, but there is a problem, guys. When you run this code, you'll get an error in the output. Okay, let me run and show you first. Okay, run it. You'll get an error in the output. The reason here is, this is not a normal init function. It has some parameters, as you can see, right? So if this particular, in the previous session also, I used the init function, guys, but there were no parameters. So this was enough. Okay, this way of creating the object for the car class is enough when the init function doesn't have any parameters. But when the init function has some additional parameters apart from this self, which comes by default, okay, then when you are creating an object for the car class, you have to make sure that you have to provide arguments for each and every parameter of this init function. Then only this error will go away or will not come, okay? Here you need to pass the arguments from the car object creation, okay? So here model is there. So here I'll say Benz A class, okay, comma color. We need to pass the color also as an argument. While creating an object for the car class, we have to pass the arguments, okay? The same statement itself. Color is red color and cost is 50 lakhs, okay? Cost is 50 lakhs. So now it will work, guys, okay? You will not get any output, okay? Here, okay, when you create an object for the car class and pass the arguments required for this init function will be called automatically, but nothing will happen because when init function is called, this initialization is done, but there is no print statement here, right? This initialization is done, but there is no print statement inside this init function. So what will happen? You'll not get any output. You'll not see this error, but you'll not get any output. Run this, you see, you'll not get any output because only initialization happened here, okay? Only the initialization happened, nothing much. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to call this print car details, okay? To check whether this initialization is done properly or not by this init function, I need to call this print car details. But this is not init function, guys. Print car details is a function. It's a normal function. So how to call the normal functions in Python? For that, guys, we have to use the object reference of this object. Here, object is created. Using the object reference of this particular, okay, object, we need to call this print car details, okay? As you already know in the previous sessions, so here I will create an object reference, BAC is equal to, okay? This variable is referring to this object. So this is called as object reference. Now BAC dot, I need to call this print car details. Okay, when I specifically call this print car details by using the object reference of this particular object, what will happen? When I run this code, what will happen first of all? So this object, okay, when you create this car class object, so what will happen? This init function will be called and this Benz A class will be stored into model. Red will be going and falling into the color and 50 lakhs will go into the cost. And this initialization, the model Benz A class will be initialized or assigned to self.model. That is class variable self.model. Self.color class variable will be assigned or initialized with this red color, which is received to this color. And self.cost of this car class will be assigned with this cost known as 50 lakhs, like that. Okay, initialization will be done. And after initialization is done, okay, so this object reference is referring to this particular object. Using the object reference, we are specifically calling print car details. Since initialization is already done, the model of the car is self.model. What is self.model now after initialization? Benz A class. So Benz A class will be printed. The color of the car is red will be printed. The cost of the car is 50 lakhs will be printed. Run it. You see, the model of the car is Benz A class. The color of the car is red. The cost of the car is 50 lakhs got printed. Similarly, I'll create another object. You can create multiple objects for the same class. Okay, here only BAC is only one object reference, which is referring to this particular first object. Okay, similarly, you can create multiple objects, guys. How to create multiple objects? So again, okay, same statement car, and you need to pass some arguments. This time I'll pass different arguments, say Audi superhero. Okay, Audi superhero, and here I'll say blue, and here I'll say 75 lakhs. Okay, 75 lakhs. 75 lakhs. Okay. So when this particular object is created, again, this init function of this car class will be automatically called, and you know, right, Audi superhero will go into model, blue will go into color, and this 75 lakhs will go into cost, and this initialization will be done. And you need to call this print car details to see whether this initialization is properly done or not. For that, I need to create the object reference for this object, that is ASH is equal to, okay. Now, ASH dot print car details, I will say, okay. The moment this thing is called, if the initialization is done, the model of the car is Audi superhero. The color of the car is blue. The cost of the car is 75 lakhs should be printed in the output. Okay, since two objects are created here and two object reference using which we are calling this print car statements, let me put a kind of separation here so that this will be called two times. Print car details is being called two times. So for each and every output, I just want to separate it. Okay, so using this line, I want to separate it. Okay, so run this. You see, the model of the car is for the first object, guys. Okay, for the first object, using the first object reference, we are calling this print car details, where you see the model of the car is Benz A-Class, the color of the car is red, the cost of the car is 50 lakhs got printed. For the second object, using the object reference, when we call this print car details, since the initialization is already done, the model of the car is Audi superhero, the color of the car is blue, the cost of the car is 75 lakhs got printed. So there is much, guys, okay? There is much to be, more to be explained, actually. I need to explain about car and these objects, what exactly the class is, okay? And why we are able to create multiple objects for this car class, and what is the theory or funda behind that, okay? Everything I'm going to explain in the next session, guys. So for this session, the main purpose is to explain about initializing the class variables using init function in Python. That's the main purpose of init function, guys, to initialize the class variables in Python. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.